Remember also that Rasulullah said that in the last days the deen would come to this continent. You are the future of Islam and you are the future of your country. And we hope that you will be the highest and best citizens of this country until by your nobility and your excellence you will draw the whole country into the deen of Islam. That is your destiny, to fulfill this duty and this task, to be the bearers of Islam for the future and to make this a Muslim country. And we are fortunate that you have come through a struggle for freedom and you gained a political freedom. Beyond that is another story, which is financial and economic freedom, which has not been gained, but it cannot be gained by terror or by struggle. It can be gained only by men with a new spirit who restore the law of Islam in a just way. Big responsibilities on your shoulders, and those who say Shahada today will become among the noblest people in the world today, because the light of Islam has flourished in this country over the last few years, and it will continue to flourish until we see the country Muslim. And this continent is the continent of Islam, from Tangier and Cairo in the north to Cape Town in the south, by the power of Allah. Rasulullah was sitting at Kaaba with Abu Dharr and said, "Oh Abu Dharr, who are the most miserable people in the world?" And he said, "Who are they, Rasul?" Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he said, "The very rich, unless they give in front of them, behind them, to the right of them, and to the left." So this is the deen we have taken on, is to bring health to our society and well-being to our society, and for all of the Muslims to emerge as people of enormous nobility and courage and civic splendor. Because remember, the byproduct of the deen of Islam, which is itself all worship of Allah, its byproduct is a great civilization. And this civilization is in your hands to create in the future. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless everybody in this hall. We ask Allah's blessing on everybody, and we ask Allah's mercy and light on those people who say Shahada this afternoon. And we ask that this be the beginning, and that from this will flow a river of lights through the lands of Africa. Subhanahu wa ta'ala.
مولاي صل وسلم دائما وابدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم، يا ربي صل على محمد وعلى سيدنا عليه وصحبه
five obligations. First one is to do what you are about to do. It's shahada. So you have to say there is no God except Allah.
And
you have to say yes. And Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Okay, you say it in Arabic. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. This is the first obligation. The second is that you have to pray five times a day. You will have to pay zakah. It's a tax, a payment that you have to make or receive. The zakat is for the poor, so either you receive the payment or you have to pay to the poor. Depending. Okay? Then you have to fast during the month of Ramadan.
Is that the third obligation?
This is the fourth obligation. Shahada, Salat, that's the prayers, then the payment, and the fourth is the fasting. The fasting, which means that from sunrise to sunset, you cannot eat, or drink, or have sexual intercourse.
During the month?
During that month. And then the fifth obligation, not only if you can, you have to go to Mecca once in your lifetime if you can.
To make the pilgrimage.
Ah, nah, nah, nah. Do you agree with that?
Yes.
Then you are welcome.
You.
Now you have to repeat after me. Ashadu.
Ashadu.
An la ilaha. إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. And again, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. You are a Muslim. Do you have a name in mind? A name for yourself?
For myself. Yeah, but never thought of it.
Yeah. We can give you one if you want.
Yes, yeah, it's okay.
You want me to give you one?
Yes.
I'm going to give you the name Abdul Hakim.
Abdul Hakim. Abdul Hakim.
Abdul Hakim.
من حيث لم يدري أحد.
حسن
سامي وحشة سامي سامي جوع ومن شبعي فربما خمصات شر المئة خامي واستغرق دمعي.